poem number 4, A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. 1795 to 1821. This John Keats was a British romantic poet. The following poem is an excerpt from his poem Endymion, a Poetic Romance. The poem is based on a Greek legend and in which Endymion, a beautiful young shepherd and poet who lived on Mount Latmon, had a vision of Cynthia, the moon goddess. The enchanted youth resolved to seek her out and so wandered away through the forest and down under the sea. So today we will discuss the poem Thing of Beauty. Before you read, what pleasure does a beautiful thing give us? Are beautiful things worth treasuring? First 4 lines. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its liveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health, and quiet breathing. So in the beginning, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. So thing of beauty means the nature or the things in the nature, which is the joy for everyone. So why here poet is thinking that a thing of beauty is a joy forever? Because nature is everlasting. And in this everlasting phase of the nature, what will happen? That everyone will feel happy, joy. So that understanding of the nature, it will give everyone the joy of understanding. And one more thing here, its loveliness increases, means the beauty of the nature, it is increases the happiness. Whenever you will go in the field of happiness, what will happen? You will enjoy. Means in earlier poem Keeping Quiet, we have observed that there is a sadness of never understanding ourselves. So here also we can say that when we are not understanding ourselves, what to do? Go in the nature, go in the company of the nature, you will find your stress will decrease, your tension will decrease, and the level of happiness will increase. Understanding will increase, the burden will release, and you will feel very happy. So here, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. And this joy of yourself or joy in the company of the nature, it will not fade. Or the beauty of that things in the nature, it will not fade. It will not vanish. It will be there. So here its loveliness increases, it will not pass into nothingness, and it will never pass into nothingness, because whenever you will go in the company of the nature, you will feel better. So that understanding of the nature will help you to keep yourself from the such type of stressful atmosphere. In modern life, we are facing the major problem. That is, everyone is stressful. Maybe the reason may be of duty, reason may be of nowadays so many people, they are expecting more from employees. So here time is less and target may be given more. So you can observe the marketing department, salesmen, how they are facing the problem. Means more than 12 hours also some employees they are working. So the world is now expecting more, the demands are more, and in that demands everyone you should be happy. So how that happiness will maintain, how that happiness will be maintained, it will be maintained when you will go in the company of the nature. Its loveliness increases, it will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us. But bower means the comfort, that shade, it will keep for us. Means it will not pass into nothingness. The beauty of the nature, it will not pass into nothingness. Beauty of the things in the nature, it will not pass into nothingness. But what will be the positivity there, but will keep a bower quiet for us. But like a shade, we will have a comfort in the company of the nature and a sleep full of sweet dreams. When we are happy, that sweet dreams means that sound sleep will help you, and everybody can understand that when you will have a sound sleep, your health will be good. So here, and health and quiet breathing. And when we are stressful, you can observe your breathing. It is not normal breathing. When you are fearful, you observe your breathing. It is not normal breathing. So quiet breathing, natural breathing is important. How that natural breathing will be changed? When you will have a stress, burden, nervousness, depression. So all that negative things, when it will be filled in your mind, what will happen? You will not enjoy the life. And why we are living life? And that sadness will lead to the suicide. That depression will lead to the suicide cases. If you will analyze so many people, why they are doing suicide, you will understand that they are not understanding what they are doing, why they are stressful. So this is important. Then therefore on every morrow, so here the morrow means morning, every morrow, are we breathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth? That are we decorating our earth? Are we contributing our earth? Are we contributing this mother earth with positive things, means planting trees or taking care of the trees, conservation of the forest? Are we doing it? Are we taking care of this natural cycle? Are we helping others to do that work? So here, are we breathing? Are we decorating? Are we breathing the flowery band to bind us to the earth? Because this flowery band means the good work. Means here we have to save the nature, or the tasks which are useful for the nature. It is here reflected in another way, that are we breathing, are we doing at least one positive task in the morning, every morning, just to water the plant? It may be one small task, but are we doing that? Are we decorating the earth with flowers, with different trees? And then that oxygen level will increase, pollution will decrease, or so many things, whatever we can understand, it will happen. Then, spite of discordance of the inhuman death of noble natures. Spite of discordance, here discordance means negativity. This negativity, once it will go, what will happen? No one will understand So despite of discordance, that nervousness of the inhuman dearth of noble natures, inhuman dearth of noble, inhuman, why we are behaving inhuman? The reason may be we want money, that greediness we have. For the sake of greediness, we would be, for the sake of greediness, we would be more stressful. We would do such type of tasks which are wrong to the world. So here, inhuman dearth of noble nature. So actually we should follow the path of noble activities, noble natures. But what we are doing, we are not following the path of noble nature, and we are away from that. So of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways. So here poet is referring from the line that spite of discordance, of the inhuman death, of noble natures, of gloomy days. Why the days would be gloomy? Because you all are your mind is filled with the negativity. You are doing the wrong task. You are thinking with a negative way. Your tasks are such type of tasks which are not good to the world, or inhuman task, inhuman activities. That activities are not noble activities. If that is noble, then the world can get something from that. Of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching. So here, made for our searching means all that over darkened ways, unhealthy ways. Why? Because some they are doing smuggling of drugs, some they have wrong habits, means they are joined to the terrorist groups, some they are doing such type of task, means deforestation, or they are burning the forest, or such type of unhealthy ways and over darkened ways. Some they can easily kill the human beings or any other species for their selfish behavior. All that over darkened ways made for our searching. And if we wish to realize that all that tasks are not good, what we have to do, if we wish to do that, yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. So, in the beginning, poet's mood is different. Then, from spite of discordance to made for our searching, here all that negative things, whichever it is observed in this world, it is mentioned. And now, again poet mood is changed, and poet is referring. What is the poet referring? Made for our searching as, in spite of all, okay, all that negative things are exist in this world. Poet is mentioning, poet is confessing that yes, everything it is exist, but yes, in spite of all, some hope here, it is still there. And what is that hope? The nature. When you will go in the company of the nature, you can change all that things. So here, some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits. So that dark spirits means negativity, wrong deeds. So when you are doing the wrong deeds, what will happen? All that things will be, wrong things will happen, but in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall. So this pall word means the cover of that negative things. It will vanish. It will go. When you will be in the company of the nature. Or the shape of beauty, some shape of beauty will change that negativity, feeling of not understanding yourself, or the thought of destruction of the world. In that some shape of beauty here, poet is mentioning in that, such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon. So here, sun, the beauty of the sun, the regularity of the sun, the brightness of the sun, the energy of the sun, everybody can understand. So it will not fade away, and it will give you energy every time. The moon. So here, the peaceful, calm, but bright light, positivity, happiness, when you will enjoy your life in moonlight, stars are there, moon, everything, that atmosphere, in that atmosphere, your tension will decrease, happiness will increase, and you will not feel stressful when you will be in the company of the nature, like the thing here it is mentioned as a moon. So here the moon, the old and young trees. So the trees may be old or young, but that tree will give you the shade, the tree will give you the comfort, the tree will give you the oxygen, and so many things, means fruits, flowers, fragrance, so many things, because the nature of the trees are not selfish. So whatever it is there with the tree, it will be given to you. So when you will be in the company of the trees, maybe it is old or young, it will give you that happiness. Sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep, and such are daffodils with the green world they live in. So poet is mentioning that old and young trees, or the beautiful daffodils, the flowers, there are so many flowers, and that suppose the flower like the daffodils here poet is mentioning, that such are daffodils with green world they live in, and that green world is the nature, and in that nature there are so many flowers like daffodils which will give you the comfort, the beauty, the fragrance, and in that company you will not have any tension, stress, nervousness will go, and slowly, slowly that happiness will come. And clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make against the hot season. And the clear rills, when you are going anywhere in the season of rainy season, the such type of clear rills on mountain regions you can observe, and that clear rills will be still there here in the season of fourth season, especially the summer season. If you will go there, that clear rills means it, that rills will start in the rainy season, but it will be still there in some mountain ranges. You can enjoy that clear rills, and especially the sprinkling of the water nearby that rills, and that rills will give you comfort against the hot season. It will be the cooling covert make against the hot season. That is the natural comfort, means just sitting in the room and taking the, means the cool breath of the whatever the instruments, means AC or cooler or something, whatever it is there in our house, we are enjoying that. But when you will go in the company of the nature, such type of natural things will give you that happiness. And again, one more example. the mid-forest brake, rich with a sprinkling of fair musk roses. And in the mid-forest, those musk roses, how that musk rose blooms. And the beauty of that musk rose, if you will go there and silently you will observe for some hours, what will happen? You will not have any tension, and your negativity in your mind, it will go, and you will be very positive in understanding. So here, it is not only the nature or the things from the nature, it is beautiful, but one more thing, and such too is the grandeur of the dooms we have imagined for the mighty dead. So mighty dead means great personalities in this world. So their great contribution to the world. So from India, if we will take, then Mahatma Gandhi, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, Mahatma Phule. There are so many people. Their contribution to the world is good. So they are the mighty dead, because they have given contribution to the world. And here it is magnificent, grandeur. The word grandeur, it is used here. It is magnificent. Why? Because whatever they have given the contribution, their philosophy, their deeds, their good deeds, everyone is now sharing their good deeds, and we are also getting motivation through their deeds. And such too is the grandeur of dooms we have imagined for mighty deed. All lovely tales that we have heard or read. So here, poet is mentioning that all lovely tales about them, or stories about the great personalities from the world. Why we are listening that stories, why we are reading that stories? Because all that stories gives us the life, how to live life. Means obstacles were also there to them. Social problems were there, financial problems were there, but how they fight with that problems? Suicide is not the way, or to take the wrong path to achieve something, it is not the good way, or the unhealthy ways, or over darkened ways, or inhuman death of the noble natures, all that things, that is not good to follow, but to follow the path of the nature. Here all lovely tales that we have heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal drink. And all that things, whatever we have heard about the mighty dead or the great personalities in the history, when we are reading their autobiographies, again that image, their contribution, their good deeds, it would come into your mind, and your understanding will change. Your perspective about the world will change. You will feel that whatever now I am suffering, it is very less as compared to the great personalities in the world. So students read their autobiographies, biographies. So it will always help. The stories about them, the tales about them, it may be heard or read. What is that? An endless fountain of immortal drink, pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. Pouring unto us from the heaven's brink means heaven is the holy place. In religious book it is mentioned, that is, the heaven is the holy place, and from one corner of that holy place, from the heaven, what is happening? Pouring unto us means that happiness, or the elixir, or that source of happiness. And how is that source? An endless fountain of immortal drink. And that is endless fountain of immortal drink, elixir, that it is coming from the heaven. God and goddesses are there in that heaven, and they are pouring us that happiness. Means the beauty of the nature, it is exist, it will not fade, it will not pass into nothingness. So in the beginning itself, the one line, first line, think of beauty is a joy forever. And this is metaphor, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. Why? Because it will not fade. Day means the world is changing. Nowadays in modern world, we are facing so many problems. But then also, whenever you will feel, you go in the company of the nature, or there are so many nice gardens, or some areas, especially in some countries, some areas are designed that in this modern era also, people will go there and they will introspect. They will have understanding to the world. So here, the loveliness means the things or the nature's loveliness, it will increase, it will not decrease, it will never pass into nothingness. So here, understanding is important. It will never pass into the nothingness. An endless fountain of immortal drink pouring us from heaven's brink. So poet ends the poem with such type of line. So understanding is important, that some shapes of beauty in that, maybe the sun, moon, trees, old or young, or the musk roses, daffodils or clear rills, and the mighty dead or great personalities in the world, they may give you such type of things which you will never forget. Or whenever you are stressful, it is the request of poet. Poet is saying everyone that go in the company of the nature. And when you will go in the company of the nature, whatever good thoughts, it is there. It is good thoughts are exist in your mind, exist in your heart, and that will come out. And whatever the negativity, it will go, it will decrease, your tension will decrease, and you will feel comfort. You will understand that why I am doing this. And when you will be happy with your own ideas, understandings, all that important things, whatever you are doing, whatever role you are playing, you will be in a mood to sustain that activities. You will strengthen your own abilities in the company of the nature. So here, through this poem, A Thing of Beauty, John Keats highlighted the importance of nature or the things in the nature. It is everlasting. It will not be only the thing which is partial thing. Here it would be for the whole world. And this poem is very important, that whenever we are stressful, we must enjoy ourselves in the company of the nature. So I feel that you have understood the main concept of the poem. Thank you.